So we're gonna go see this largest diamond here in the Museum of Natural History. So that would be this room here. Oh, there it is. It's called the Hope Diamond. This is a beryl crystal found. It's not that I thought it would be. That's what they're saying. I thought the largest one was the black diamond, but. Three million?
3 million.
Probably at least. I thought the largest diamond was a black diamond based on my Google research, but she's saying this Titanic blue diamond is, so I'm confused about it. But $3 million would buy me my dream home. I don't see this. It looks fake, actually. But there it is. That's the,
Oh, I know. I thought it was coming up here. Okay, let's just stay right here and we'll wait. Oh, see, I came all the way over here.
So. So that's the blue diamond. Hope Diamond has crossed oceans and continents and passed from kings to commoners. It was recut and resized and reduced in size twice, but has steadily increased in value from India. Drawn by John Baptiste Tavernier's father, who is Tavernier's father, who was writing his son's journal. These drawings are about the size of Tavernier's diamonds. It was cut in the Indian cell, which and emphasize weight rather than brilliance, probably on the initial census. So it went to France. It was 67 and the 8th carat then. At 250 million. Perfect.
Yes.
It was 112 carats.
So it was originally from the India. Enzo and Anna Marie Antoinette,
as she's being
broke out of the palace. So they say that this is a cursed diamond.
It was stolen.
Suicide, but everybody said nope, it's the diamond. 40 people have come forward and said this diamond ruined my life. Also, if you shine an infrared light on it for 30 seconds, it will glow if you take the light off. So it's always had some other world. Finally, it ends up in the hands of Harry Winston, the ruler of New York, and he just sends it straight through the mail, USPS, to the Smithsonian. So he got away from the curse. And now that it's been on display, nobody's been cursed.